Good morning and welcome to the time of prayer with Bethel AME Church here in Baltimore, Maryland, where the pastor is the Reverend Patrick D. Claiborne, and his wife stands beside him, the wonderful Reverend Cherie Smith Claiborne, as our First Lady. And we welcome you this morning, all of the officers, ministers, and members of Bethel. We welcome you into the prayer room with Bethel AME Church this morning as we go to the throne of mercy and grace. So, beloved, if you are next to someone, or if you can holler down the hall to someone, if you can text someone, or if you can type someone's name in the chat, do whatever you can to encourage others to join us in a time of prayer. It is nothing like starting your day with God, going to his throne of mercy and grace, and letting our petitions be known, but also showing him that we love him and we are thankful and grateful for yet another day to live and to breathe and to move about and have our life and to be thankful for all of the things that God does for us. So please encourage someone to join us. Please also place your prayer request in the chat, because we do have intercessors who are praying literally 24/7. There are some intercessors that are on the phone lines now. They are on our social media pages, and some will come back later today to check the prayer request just to see what needs to be taken to the throne of mercy and grace. Excuse me. And we want to be able to pray for you and to make your desires and your requests known unto God as you also pray. So please just type in your prayer request, and as they come in, there will be those who will be able to pray for your situations. As we begin this morning, we have received some prayer requests that we would like to just call out at this time. So we are praying for support, for grace, for mercy and strength during a time of bereavement for the family of Brother Clifton Carver, the family of Brother Dwayne Dennis in the loss of his father, Charles Dennis. Services were held last week. For the family of Sister Patricia Oliver in the loss of her sister and former Bethel member, Linda Day. Services will be held on April 4th. We are also praying for comfort, strength, and peace for Sister Addie Connor in the loss of her sister, Carolyn Long. Services were held in North Carolina last week. We are praying and supporting and asking for comfort and peace for Sister Rhonda Lane and her family in the loss of Sister Rhonda Lane's brother, Edwin Lane. Please remember those families in your prayers as they seek solace in the time of grief. We are also asking for you to pray for healing, help, and hope for Sister Shantae Colbert and her granddaughter, Karima Hud, Sister Patricia Oliver's brother-in-law, Danny Day, Reverend Edwina Witherspoon's brother, Carlton Jeffers, Sister Juanita Mickens' friend, Victor Davies, Brother Bobby and Sister Vermel Wells' grandson, great-grandson, Josiah, Brother Ed Harrison's aunt, Sister Rhonda Allman's father, Vernon Hayes, Sister Estrina Calame's husband, Calvin, Sister Geneva Horton's daughter, Maria Williams, Sister Barbara Payton's father, Jesse Payton, and her cousin, Donald Garrett, Sister Betty Walker's son, Tarek Walker, Reverend Naima Kenyatta's brother, Clinton Perviance, and Sister Mary Bishop, and brother-in-law Arthur Huff, and cousin Jimmy Myers, Sister Louise Green's sisters, the Cheryl Harper and Phyllis Tolles, Scarlett Rankin's cousin, Monica Cunningham, Helby Griffin's brother, Wayne, Famika Michener's aunt, Elaine, and Tammy Blair's mother, Sylvia Rowett. We also pray for our bereaving families across the nation, our sick and shut-in members, and those overcoming COVID-19 and other illnesses, and for those in hospitals, health facilities, and other institutions. I'd like to also add to the prayers of prayers for comfort during the time of bereavement, Brother Kevin Jackson, in the loss of his sister, Karen Jackson. Please pray for Brother Jackson and his family in this sudden loss. We are also asking for your prayers for Sister Kathy Pugh, while she is away caring for her sisters who are not well. Sister Kathy Pugh's sisters, Loretta Crump, Addie Jackson, and Delphine Arrington. We also ask for your prayers for Brother Kevin and Sister Nicole Jones during the illness of their son, Tavon Rose. Now, I know those were a lot of names that were called, and that just tells us there are many that we know of and that we don't know of that are standing in the need of prayer. And quite frankly, all of us are standing in the need of prayer because all of us are asking God for strength and grace and mercy and comfort as we go from day to day. So, beloved, if you just mentioned Bethel, if you just mentioned God bless Bethel, if you just mentioned God bless those who have lost loved ones at Bethel and in other places, God bless the sick, all of the sick that were called out at Bethel and the sick around our nation. If you just give a prayer like that, God will know who you are praying for. And he will know because he's present right with us now as we called out those names. So he heard them as well. Just whisper a prayer for Bethel and all who are connected to Bethel. And I promise you, God will know exactly who you are thinking of. Some time ago, I was texting a relative of mine, and we were going back and forth with texts. And you know how when you're texting, sometimes you may type a word that you really didn't mean to type, but it is a word. So your phone won't correct it because it is a word. And this happened to me one time. I meant to say endure, and instead of saying endure, I said ensure. I can't recall the whole context of the conversation or the sentence now, but I know that I had my words mixed up, and I apologized and corrected myself. And my family member said, no, this is a good use of words because God ensures we endure. God ensures we endure. In other words, God is our strength provider. He's our strength provider. And when I was preparing for this morning, I found so many scriptures that related to the strength of God and how that strength of God flows from the Holy Spirit to us. And I did find one scripture in particular that really kind of focused on and solidified and supported this whole nation, whole notion that God endures, we endure as God ensures. God ensures we endure. He is our strength provider. And it's in Isaiah 40, 20 through 31. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. So all of us get tired from time to time. And this scripture let us know that even young people younger than us or even children get tired if they play too long, or they get tired from being in school all day and having to pay attention all day. We get tired from going to work every day, from doing the things that we need to do for our families, and then trying to carve out some time for some self-care. We all get tired from time to time. And sometimes life's situations and struggles can be exhausting. And sometimes life is just lifing. And when life is lifing, we try to roll with the punches, but we also get tired. So in this portion of Isaiah 40, verses 29 through 31, God's power and strength is always available. That's what the scripture tells us. God is never too busy. He's never too tired. God never gets sleepy. If we're praying to him, he will never say, "Hold up, I got to take a nap." God is always available to us, and his strength is our strength. When all kinds of challenges and stresses come into our lives and things just start to stress us out, and as we said, when life is lifing, we have a source of strength we can turn to. God ensures we can endure because his grace is sufficient and his strength is ever prevailing. When you get tired from the on-the-job stress, when you just want to throw up both your hands and holler because the kids are wilding out, when finances get strange and your debt is even stranger, when your health begins to challenge your abilities and your mindset and attacks your emotions, when all you hear on the news is one tragedy after another, war and rumors of war, crime running rampant within your city, and a bridge collapsing that was a major conduit for the entire nation. When all of these things come about, and when you are in your own season of grief, God's strength ensures we can endure. Have hope in the possibilities of God. Pull on his strength. He can handle you pulling on him for strength to get you through. When we hope in him, he will give us new strength to endure things we have never thought we could handle. As we are going through to get to the victorious side of our challenges, he is with us, strengthening us each day. So keep moving, keep trusting, keep believing. You don't have to depend on yourself alone, because alone without God, you're not strong enough to deal with the challenges of life. We just read through a large list of people who are in sickness or are caring for family members who are going through a time of illness. We just listed out members who have lost loved ones, and they are trying to wrap their minds around their loved one being gone, and they cannot get through it by themselves. Quite honestly, they can't get through it by themselves and with us. They need the Lord God Almighty and our prayers to get them through. So keep moving, keep trusting, keep believing. You don't have to depend on yourself alone. Depend on the strength of your Heavenly Father, your Creator. As a beloved friend of mine says, the uncreated Creator. If no one had to create him, then you know that he has the strength to deal with your problems, my problems, and so many other things if we just go to the throne of mercy and grace. God ensures that we can endure. God ensures that we can endure. And that assurance, that blessed assurance, is his strength, his power, his mercy, and his might to carry us through. I remember the song that is sung by William Murphy, "You Are My Strength." You are my strength, strength like no other that reaches out to me. In the fullness of your grace, in the power of your name, you lift me up. You are my strength, strength like no other, that reaches out to me. Let us pray. Father, we bless you. We praise you. We worship you. We honor you. We adore you. We recognize you as righteous. We recognize you as holy. We recognize you as mighty. We recognize you as our creator. We recognize you as the uncreated creator. God, when things are going awry in our lives, when we see the whole stories on the news about war and rumors of war and bridge collapsing and doors flying off of airplanes and sickness that is running through the country and even through the world and despair and hunger and strife and even strife in our own lives, God, help us to remember that your strength reaches out to us. God, when we are in doubt, when we are in fear, when we just want to throw up our hands and say, I can't take it anymore, when we are caught by unawares by death of a loved one that we weren't even expecting, and we didn't know the person would not even be with us this week who was with us last week. God, we thank you for your strength that we can draw on. We can tug on you. We can just grasp onto you, God. Just like the woman that was crawling on the ground and touched the hem of your son's garment, we can just touch your Holy Spirit. And it's all right with you because you can handle us pulling on you for strength, mercy, and grace. As I believe, God, you enjoy us depending on you. You may not enjoy the sorrow and the sickness and the sadness and the struggles that we have to go through, but you know that you are there as our strength source. So God, we thank you for the strength that reaches out to us, strength like no other. God, we thank you for the strength that is reaching out to those that have suffered loss. And we ask you to continue to wrap your Holy Spirit around them as they wrap their minds around no longer having their family member with them. God, we thank you for your strength that reaches out to the homeless, those that are unhoused in Baltimore, in New York, in California, and across the globe. God, we thank you for your strength that reaches out to them, that helps them to feel sustained through the day, from day to day. God, thank you for the person today who will reach in their pocket because they believe in you and they know that they have the strength to have the things that they have and to be stewards over the things that you have given them. So as they reach in their pocket to bless someone who is unhoused, we thank you. God, we ask you to bless those that are walking the hospital floors or waking up in a hospital room or at this moment being wheeled into an operating room or even at this moment that are sitting in a urgent care or a patient first facility or sitting in the ER in the hospital, Lord God, the patient and the one that brought them in. God, we thank you that your strength reaches out to them and they can cling to you, draw upon you, garner strength from you, even in a time of weakness, even in a time of doubt, even in a time of uncertainty. God, we can call on you. So we thank you, God. We bless you. We give you glory. We give you honor. Father, we know that we make it through day to day, not because of our own strength alone, but because your strength is there, your strength is available, and it reaches out to us. In Jesus' name, amen. Forgive me. Beloved, remember, God's strength is there, and God ensures that we endure. I'm so glad that I came across that whole understanding just through a misunderstanding of a word in a conversation. That's how God is. He will speak to us in the most unlikely situations. So, beloveds, keep your hearts open. Keep your spirit open. Keep your mind open so that you can always be at the ready to receive a word from the Lord. Because as he converses with us, he's downloading strength into us. as we converse with him, we are asking for the download. So beloved, believe God's strength is available for us. And even in a time when you just want to shake your head, even in a time when you may just want to get back in bed and pull the covers up over your head and say, I can't today. Even in those times, if we just pray, God, I need an ounce of your strength. If I can just get a taste of your strength, I can make it through this day and the next. Remember, God ensures that we can endure. Beloved, I'm so grateful for you coming in this morning to the room of prayer just to have a time with Jesus and to learn that God ensures that we can endure. I am grateful for the moment to take us all to the throne of mercy and grace and know that you can go to the throne of mercy and grace yourself and ask for that ounce of strength. Beloved, the Second Episcopal District, the Baltimore District, is having its 208th annual conference at Empowerment Temple this week. So Bethel will not be having Bible study this week because all of us will be attending the annual conference. If you would like a little taste of Jesus, if you would like just a few minutes of worship and praise and some word, you can come on by Empowerment Temple as well. There will be services in the evening. There will be noonday services that anyone can attend. So you can come on and join us for worship when we break from our business sessions to just spend some time in worship with the Lord, of the Lord. So you can come on out to Empowerment Temple Wednesday night, Thursday night, I believe Friday night. Every night we will be having some sort of worship service that you can come and join us in. And we are excited because we will have two ministers who will be ordained. We will have one ordained itinerant deacon, Brother Eric Medlin, and we will have a minister being ordained itinerant elder, Sister Reverend, Charlene Kelly, and that will be on Friday. So please come on out and join us for those worship sessions, and I promise you it'll be a midweek blessing for you. So no Bible study this week. We ask you to come on out every Sunday to join us for worship at 9:45 a.m. I promise you, you will get a word like you have never heard before. Our pastor knows how to break the word down so that we can understand it and so that we can be inspired and encouraged and get that ounce of strength from the word of God to carry us through a new week. We will be back here Thursday. There will be someone here Thursday morning to take us to the throne of mercy and grace. So please check in with us again at 7 a.m. Thursday morning, so that you may also join Bethel in corporate prayer. Beloved, we thank you again this morning for joining us. Remember, God ensures that we can endure, and just an ounce of his strength will get you through any challenging moment. Have a safe and wonderful day, a blessed and prosperous week, and draw on the strength of God, because God ensures so we can endure. God bless you.